Hey guys, and welcome back to another train simulator video. Morning driver, today your first service is the peak time 1F90 from Eastbourne to London Bridge. We'll call it Wivelsfield, Hayward's Heath, Balcombe, Gatwick Airport, East Croydon, and London Bridge. No delays are expected for this journey. Okay then. Let's open the doors at Wivelsfield. Early morning service. It is only 6:18 in the morning. Obviously, we did start at Eastbourne at 5:34. We are driving our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 car train. Nice. Change that to 12. The light should be here somewhere. Yes, they are. And normally these trains go towards London Victoria, but it's quite busy, so we are going to be going to London Bridge instead. It will be really cool to actually do the full journey between Eastbourne and London Victoria, or London Bridge. But yeah, fortunately not today. We are starting at Wivelsfield. And we are ready to go. So let's get going. Next station, Hayward's Heath, which is just under 3 miles away. Quite a while since I've driven on the 11 Brighton route, the 377. I think one of you mentioned that you want to see a scenario on this route, on this train, so I thought let me do this scenario. Driving a long 12 car 377. I'm pretty sure Hayward's Heath has a long enough platform to fit our 12 car train. It will be a tight squeeze at all stations, but was almost perfect. Okay. a bit early there, but I don't think the back of the train is on the platform, but these are walk-through trains anyway, so you might as well take advantage of those and walk through this train if you want to get off at the station. Try to get some thumbnails. Any passengers here? Nope. Well, it is quite an early service anyway, so that does make sense. So we do have a bit of a wait here. I think we're departing at 6:24. 6:25, okay. So we do have a bit of a wait here. Way to East Croydon as well, so not too bad. Might as well check out some of the senior out since we're here. What does that sound? I think it's coming from this. Interesting sound. And this train is ready to depart. Please man doors. Any second now. Just Trains have released their Christmas sale where pretty much most things are 50% off, or in fact everything, so that's pretty good. I am still waiting for the Ultra Powerhouse sale. I might be buying some things, so stay tuned for that. Not too sure what I am going to be buying, but we'll see. If I remember. There was actually another sale at Black Friday in our Trump Firehouse, but I forgot to buy anything. And I didn't realize it was too late. I think we meant to go a bit faster than this because we might have to do some late braking again at the previous station. are going slightly uphill now, so that's okay. Slow down a bit. Yeah, I kind of feel like that we went a bit slow there. We might be slightly late. Brakes on this train are absolutely amazing. Really, really good. And we are, look at that, we are on time. 3 seconds early actually, so that's not too bad. Not the best station for a screenshot, but I'll take one anyway. Actually, that's not too bad actually. That's kind of weird. Look how high the platform is, and look how... Actually, is that the same height? No, it's not, is it? I can't really tell. I'm pretty sure it's there is a step up onto the platform. It doesn't look level to me. Anyways. Look how long our train is. Holy damn. Yeah, we're departing at 6:30. Our arrival at London Bridge is 12 past 7. Next station is Gatwick Airport, which is not too far from here, I don't think. Yeah, only 7 miles, and then it's obviously 23 and then 33. ETA is just coming down right now, which is okay, but at the same time, I don't really know what's happening. We got a bit of a journey up until Gary Airport, and our arrival is at 6:40. Don't want to be waiting at Gary Airport for like 3 minutes. I think that would be quite annoying for our driver. Just waiting for the time to depart. Because 3 minutes would take a long time as well. Going to Gatwick Airport, so that train is probably doing a bit of a longer journey towards Brighton. Gatwick Airport. we'll be turning our right. The trains towards the Victoria turn left, so yeah. I'm a bit surprised that we're on these tracks. Airports, but that's okay. Welcome to Gatwick Airport. Which doesn't look too bad at night. A bunch of planes here. Plane Airways, not British Airways. Airbus 310. Very nice. So where's the train station again? Is it here? Oh, I'm lost now. I've lost my train. Should be somewhere. See a plane landing at Gatwick Airport in the background. city, I think, is broken because, I don't know, I just kind of feel like it's not updating as fast as I would like. So I still have 11 miles to go, so I guess that could be right, maybe. Wait, we are going down the map, so a different way towards East Croydon. I think we're going on a tunnel now, which is not ideal, but I guess this is our route for today. And into the tunnel we go. I believe we're going to be connecting to the other pieces of the track soon. Operator. joining up to the other tracks. Croydon, approaching East Croydon very soon. Yeah, it looks like we are going to be sliding late. Probably drove a bit slower than I should have, but that's okay. Do have 2 minutes at East Croydon to wait for anyways. Spend a bit, save a bit of time there. much 20 seconds late, as I thought. Pretty empty East Croydon station. It looks quite nice with all the lights on though. We have a 2 minute wait here until 6:59, and then we're going to be departing for London Bridge. Can I hear a train? I think I can. Just can't see it. So if you're wondering where I did my train spotting scenario for this station, it was basically here. So you see these two buildings here, I literally stood that in here. Actually, that's the wrong one. My bad. I think it's this one, yeah. So I just stood here and yeah, watch the trains fly past. A really good spot for train spotting, actually, if you could just go on top of this building. I was gonna take a screenshot, but this message came up, so that was a bit annoying. But yeah, hello driver, we have some signaling issues at Newell Junction. Please request SPAD at any red signal you encounter from here by pressing tab. Okay then. Signal problems, so yeah. You know, we'll depart at like exactly 7 o'clock. Because we do have 10 miles still to go, and we don't want to arrive a bit too early, so yeah. We'll depart at 7 o'clock in the morning on the dot. Another southern service arrives at East Croydon. Not seeing any 455s. It's a bit sad. It's jamming. Okay, this train is ready to depart. Please mind the doors. If you are going to Victoria, we'll be going on the right hand side, left hand side, sorry. We're turning right towards Norwood Junction. Brown service, I see. Yes, it is. There's a typo screenshot. Yes, it is. You know what? Don't worry about it. Nice to see a 378. I actually went in the brand new class 700. Brand new overground train, which I believe is a class 710 or something like that. And yeah, it was pretty similar to the 378 on the line. The interior looked pretty much the same. It just sounded different, obviously, with different trains, so yeah. That was really cool. I actually went on that train between Clapham Junction and Wandsworth Road Station, so yeah. I have seen them quite a lot at Wilson Junction Depot, but I'm guessing on some routes they are already released onto the tracks. picked up a bit of a cold, so I do apologize for my sneezing. It's P10 now, so I should see quite a lot of trains on the bridge. Once again, I have driven a bit slow. And we are probably going to be a little bit late as well. But anyways, 20, 30 seconds late is not going to make a big difference to our passengers. Not like there's many passengers on our train anyway, because it's quite early in the morning. As we approach London Bridge platform 10, our journey ends. Now we can go all the way right to the end of the barrier because this is not the Chatham mainline. But that means it will kick in if we go with the buffers. We are literally perfect on time, perfect. Yeah, our train is well, let's just say our train is a bit too long. I don't think 12 car trains run to London Bridge unless they have made longer platforms, which I believe they probably have done. Obviously it's quite old route, so it's not updated very well. This is probably from like 5-10 years ago. Yeah, we have completed the scenario. Give it a thumbs up, spinning once, which is absolutely okay. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, give it a like, share it with your friends, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.